In this example, we are required to find the total electrostatic energy of the system of two concentric shells shown in figure. Here the shell radii are A and B and the charges are Q1 and Q2. Now in this situation, there are two ways to find out the total electrostatic energy of the system. Let's use first the method 1, that is by summing up all the energies self as well as interaction. Then we can simply write the total electrostatic energy of system, say it is given as E total, it can be written as self energy of the shell having charge Q1 plus self energy of the shell having charge Q2 plus the interaction energy of the shells 1 and 2. Now in this situation, this total energy can be directly given as self energy of the shell Q1 as it is a hollow sphere having a charge Q1 which is uniformly distributed on the shell, it is of radius A, it can be written as KQ1 square by 2A, which we already studied that self energy of a hollow or a conducting uniformly charged sphere is given by KQ square by 2R. And similarly, the self energy of the outer shell can also be written as KQ2 square by 2B. And if we wish to find out the interaction energy of these two shells, then it can be easily calculated by finding the potential of one shell due to the other multiplied with its own charge. So here it can be written as Q1 multiplied by the potential of this shell due to Q2, that is KQ2 by B. So in this situation, or vice versa also we can do, we can find out the potential of Q2 due to Q1 and we can multiply it with the charge Q2 also. So in this situation, the result will be KQ1 square by 2A plus KQ2 square by 2B plus KQ1 Q2 by B. That will be the answer to this problem for the total electrostatic energy of the system of these two concentric shells. The same result can also be obtained by another method by finding out the total field energy in the system. Let's continue on the next sheet. Let us discuss the method 2 for calculation of the total energy of the system of concentric shells. In this situation, we can directly state that electric field inside the inner shell is equal to zero. So, there won't exist any field energy in the region inside the inner conducting shell. And if we talk about the region between the two shells, there exists electric field only due to the charge Q1. And in the outermost region, electric field exists due to both of these shells. Now in this situation, to evaluate the field energy, let us consider an elemental shell at a distance x between the two shells and say the shell is of width dx. Here we are considering an elemental shell of width dx and radii x. Its radius x from the common center, then in this situation we can say the total field energy associated with the system is, here we can write, again it is E total, that will be the total energy because we know whenever some work is done in charging a system or assembling a system of charges, it is always stored in form of the total field energy of the system. So here E total can be first calculated. The field energy from radii A to B, that will be integration from A to B. It is half epsilon naught electric field in this inner region, which can be written as E1 square multiplied by the volume of the shell, that is 4 pi x square dx. Plus, the same integration we can carry out in the outer region like at a distance x. If we consider an elemental shell of width dx and the shell is of radius x in the outer region where we can say electric field is E2, then this integration of field energy from the outer surface of outer shell to the infinity, that will be from B to infinity, it is again half epsilon naught E2 square multiplied by 4 pi x square dx. Now, if we just substitute the values here, E total can be written as integration from A to B half epsilon naught. Electric field in the inner region is only due to the charge Q1, so it can be written as KQ1 by x square whole square multiplied by 4 pi x square dx plus in the outer region electric field will be due to both of these charges. We can calculate here the electric field by assuming the two charges appearing at the common center of the sphere, so it can be written as B to infinity half epsilon naught. Electric field at this point can be written as KQ1 plus Q2 by x square whole square multiplied by 4 pi x square dx. Now you can very easily find out these integrals, and after evaluation I am just writing down the result, and for all the students I am just leaving it as an exercise to evaluate these integrals. The result will be same what we obtained on the previous sheet by the direct method, that is KQ1 square by 2A plus KQ2 square by 2B plus KQ1 Q2 by B. All of you should just verify this answer after evaluating the integral, you are getting this or not. Just verify it and be comfortable with both of these methods. When are required, you can use.